Okay, thank you for guys. It's very cold and not raining, but in Japan, so hot and humid. So I take only the not so wearable issue, so I'm a little bit cold. Please don't blame me. So I will speak later. So, I'm also good at English, so please not so blame me. So we are now doing development of database integration in Japan. And this center, I came from Database Center for Life Science, is a national institute, not a private sector, but many Japanese biologists asked me to analyze data for money using their grants. But I cannot do so because my main task is to make the integration of the database in Japan. So that's a primary point. Okay. And we are, but we call our activity as a Togo DB. Our institute is DBCS, but we call our activity as a Togo DB. Togo means integration in Japan, Japanese. So Togo is not a general, I'm not sure, not a health Togo or some other. It's not a name of some old person, but this is simply a name for integration in Japanese. Okay, so we are to be blamed. So so I said before this before that the our project is the integration database project in Japan and in life science, and we are collecting the database to recycle the data in life science. And provide provide the data which they can easily reuse, and we retain the data, which is part of the public data. And our headquarters is called NBDC, National Bio Database Center. Very complicated, but this is a funding agency. So we call this Togo headquarters and simply NBDC. They have another separate. And website describe this, and thank you. Thank you so much. Yes. Okay. So and our center is one of the institute for under the NBDC DBCLS. We are doing the technology development. And other is you may know that the DDBJ. DDBJ is a DNA data bank in Japan, and they are DNA data archiver, primary archiver compared with the NCBI and EBI. They are also archiving the DNA data, not only sequence, but also metadata for the DNA data. And other institutes like RIKEN and Tokyo, the University of Tokyo, organizing data in collaboration with other institutes and universities in Tokyo, in Japan. Okay. So DBCS, NBDC portal is like this, and too many services, but I want to introduce only one for the database catalog. Database catalog is a catalog database, and it is useful primarily for Japanese database, but we are also collecting such a database in the world, and opening the as a yellow page like this one. So you can also use this for your sector or some other. Okay. This database is all, everything is free. This is Nagano, not Queenstown. This is Nagano, it's the Yatsugatake mountain, and this is me, and my collaborators are expressing that our database is free and no registration needed, and not only for academia, but also for profit, because I gave a lot of lectures and a presentation in Japan. They asked me about such issues for especially pharmaceutical companies guys asking me about such an issue too much, so I I do this for the process. Okay, big data in life science, this is the main issue. And you may imagine that big data in life science is a sequence from NGS, next generation sequencer, and expression, gene expression data from microarray experiments or some others. And these are some correlation. And these data from mostly from machines like Illumina, GA2, and some others. By the way, this illustration is freely available from our institute. And this is we have this picture gallery like this. This is a Creative Commons CC BY licensed, and you can make use of this illustration. And also, this is a genome lunch box. you can feel your organism or species in this, and you can eat for another. It's a genome lunch box that we are now spreading in the world. It's from Japan. Sorry, I will go back. And you may know that only one sample is from NGS is over 100 mega lines and 2 gigabytes each. So huge, so hard to use in your PC like this one. So you must use Unix and command line or some others. And you may know that in a previous talk, there are ethics issues in a personal human genome. So it's hard to only put that on the hard disk. Any other might use such a precious data. It's a very big problem. So in Japan, very, very big problem. So now we are now caring about it. And machines, data from machines, it is okay compared with the Twitter tweets or Facebook natural language input. But so many variations in such data. In a data format, some other vendors might provide another data format for their own. So it's very bad issue. And the application for them is so many variations, resequencing or de novo seq or RNA-seq or some others. And now this XXSeq is now expanding. So it's very hard to make use of data. And the last thing is granularity of metadata. Some guys describe so many descriptions about their data, but others not. So they only put their data for the publication. So it's very problem issue for us because we want to have a unique data for a unique and precious unique data for them. I'm sorry. Okay. And to make sense of the big data, we are now doing three issues. One is exhaustive but functional index for them. And second is a search engine for life science. We are making such a search engine now. And the last thing is a highly curated data set for them. That's the three points now in our institute. So these three is already in public domain, and you can make use of our service for them. The first is a yellow page for NGS data archive called DBCLS SRA, and the second is a search engine for nucleotide sequence, is ZZRNA. I'll explain later this one. And the last is a summarization and the visualization of reference transcriptome data called REPSEC, REPEX, not REPSEC. Okay. The first thing is a DBCLS SRA. You may take public data from SRA database, and you will search the data and download the data and check the quality and data processing and do the analysis. And data processing and analysis is each issue, and many people think how to analyze them. So these issues are, these points are quite the same in the researchers. So we provide a data searching interface and download engine and QC are already done before the download. So this is our system for DBCS SRA, called DBCS SRA. So please simply visit this site and see what we are doing. So I'm also without the English, so I'm sorry. So in a DBCS SRA, they have quite a simple statistics. This is statistics of NGS study as from study types. Most use case is a whole genome sequencing and others like this. And other statistics is like a platform. Illumina is the best one. And this is counted by samples, and human and mouse are in the top two. And the other feature, this is I think our unique feature. We have a table for PubMed and an SRN accession number. So you can simply find NGS data from PubMed search, like a PubMed search. You can also limit the study type or platform or species from this website. And we also have an index by disease. So you can make use of mesh hierarchy to search your favorite data. Like the central nervous system contains 16 data in the current database. And you can see the list of SRA and publication like this one. OK, this is the first part, and I will to the next part. We make a search engine for life science. This is like a Google-like RNA search engine. So we call this Googleuna. Googleuna means not Google in Japanese. So in Japan, you will laugh at me, but it is not in Japan. So you may know Japanese a little bit. You will see that Googleuna is not Google. Okay, so please run on this one. I'm sorry, this is just a joke, so please. but the engine itself is a very, very good, like a Google. It seeks a too fast, ultra-fast engine hold, including a nucleotide or amino acid search is okay, not available in NCBI, Antrim, and or LEPSEC. But we are using suffix array technology, and it is now available for all LEPSEC data. Now we are trying to do the same for GenBank, but it takes so many memories and suffix and SSD now. So now in process, and also you can make use of higher PCR primers and microarray probes. In our site, you may know that probe ID of your favorite gene, you can just insert the IDs. You can highlight the location of the probes, especially for the affymetrix gene. And gene is okay, but many people ask me that you should do as a genome version also. So he do that. This is also called a GG genome or like a Googleuna. And this is also, I can't have time to demonstrate, so. Okay. Like this one. So you can probe this sequence, and you can see in the human genome in 15 location in Watson Creek, Watson Strand, and the other is in 8. You can just insert this in a sequence and select the reference genome. You can find a location of such site in the reference genome. So the last part is REFEX. Now this is a reference expression dataset for 40 O1 dataset in only from mammalian, but we made our, we were collecting is a UEST and GeneChip and CAGE and RNA-seq data from a public database. And these are good for mammal, but I'm afraid you are not a mammal study, it is not good, but it's good because we are making use of such interface, and because we are also having body parts 3D, 3D model of human body, and you can just see like this. We have a 3D heat map in a like human body, and you can also rotate the human body and magnify the body. This is a liver specific gene, and the red part is more high expression, and blue is not. So you can see this type of 3D model of heat map from our website. You can also in the brain. So I want to see that summarize our service, and we are also developing and maintaining our service. So please ask me for the more issues to for the good service. Okay. The last is acknowledgement, and we are making how to video for Togo TV. This is talks and tutorial videos, and you can see like this is acknowledgement, and you can see like in this video. This is a Togo TV called the Google Now. This video will start. This type of tutorial videos, we made about 700 tutorial videos now. So please see our group Togo TV for all your students and postdocs. Thanks so much.